Hi again. My name is Lian Gogali. I was born and grow up in an area of Indonesia called Poso, which is in the middle of the islands of Sulawesi. You have probably never heard of it before because it's very remote and rural with only 200,000 people living in it. It has beautiful unpolluted lake with clear like the ocean. We also have 12 levels of waterfalls, rolling hills, and lots of beautiful natural scenery, maybe more beautiful than Bali. We also rich with the natural resources like marble, gold, nickel, gas, oil, and a lot of kinds of woods in the forest that untouched. There are simple and nice life there. People in Poso is also unique because it mixed between Muslim and Christian and Balinese Hindus who living together with harmony. We had intermarriage between different ethnic group and different religious belief. It changed in 1998. A fight between two teenagers who were drunk started a series of riots in Poso who divided the people. At the time, the different religions are not hostile to each other. But there is so many rumors that Muslim people were killed Christian people. And that rumors make people panic and have to protect their families, even have to join with the conflict and kill each other. So my beautiful home became a scary place. Thousands of people were killed, both Muslim and Christian. Their body thrown in the mass grave in the river until the river is full with the blood. People in Poso has a metamorphosis that before conflict, people eat fish, but during the conflict, the fish eat people. We all lost something and someone in the conflict. Everyone was a victim. The communities become enemies of each other. The conflict caused people who had a friend, family, and neighbor became killed each other, burned villages in their homes, losing their hand, flee to the jungle, and they separate live based on their religious belief. This led to the cycle of revenge and trauma for everyone. All of us living in fear. During the conflict, I was in Yogyakarta finishing my degree on theology. So I was far away from home. But my family started to tell about the condition that my family had to evacuate, living in the refugees camp with any proper food and sanitation. Some had been killed. I also hear that my family, my people in Poso, kill each other in the name of religion. In 1999, when my father passed away, I went go back to Poso, and I got to see that 10,000 families living in a refugee camp with fear and stuck in the revenge and trauma. But I also hear another stories from my family, completely different stories. These stories is about how people, Muslim and Christian, help each other, protect each other during the conflict. One story who touched me when I was there is about a group of refugees, Muslim, who starving in death in the jungle because they have no food for around 1 month. And one day, they meet with the Christian group refugees, women and children. Instead, around each other, they meet, they talk, they share, and before separate, the Muslim, the Christian community give a Muslim food and drink so they can keep alive. Another story I also hear from my family, it's about one from outside come to the village to burn it down, the village, and look for the, all the Christians to kill. Muslim women hiding the Christian community in their house and give them hard cover to put it on to disguise that they are a Muslim. And this Muslim community accompany them until arrive in the safe place in the jungle. So you can see that there are a mutual understanding between Muslim and Christian during the conflict, even in unspeakable. This story, there are so many stories are hidden on the media at the time. Never speak. In 2001, I did my research for my master's degree in refugees camp around Poso. I live with the women and children in refugees camp. After a while, I had conclusion that the conflict Poso is not about religion. It's more bigger than religion issue. Why? Because during the conflict, there are so many big business come from outside, make agreement with the local government, and to searching to exploit natural resources of people owned. So I believe that the fear and the idea in post-conflict use the religion as a tool to allow the big business to take in and to take the land, to come in to take a land. So people do not only dealing with losing their brotherhood and their neighbors, but also dealing with their losing of land. This idea is spread by government, Indonesia military and police, and media. Indonesia military and police come to Poso in the name of security, but they make a conflict worse. After a few months I live in refugees camp, I listen so many stories from women and children. I had begin to feel in debt for women and children who I research about. Because there are so many people come to Poso during the conflict and post the conflict. They become writers, researchers, fancy NGOs, got master degrees and also doctorates, but they didn't come back to Poso to help the people who they read about. Me, myself, doing the research, I got some small scholarship and I got my master degree. But I also feel unspeakable suffering of women and children. So instead to making a comfort life in Jogja, I choose to return to Poso to pay back my intent to a woman and children who I researched and written about. Why women and children? Because they are victims in the lowest layer in the conflict. During the conflict, one woman organization calculation that around 3,800 women has a sexual abuse. Some of them pregnant out of wedlock. And they are re-victimized by their community. They disgrace, abandoned, and sacrificed by their community. by the military and the police never punished until now. But the women, not only are victims, they are also survivors. During the conflict, they become protectors for their family. They have decided how family can keep alive, protect their children. And also, they are a first person who make a peace process in the grassroots with massive. They use traditional market to initiate their communication between a different religions. As I told you, during the conflict, everything took based on different religions. We can have even vegetables, fish, and tomatoes has a religion. Muslim vegetables, Christian tomatoes, etc. But the woman dismantled this idea. Me, myself, I'm not a rich woman. I come from a small village. I am a minority ethnic group in Poso. I could not walk for 2 years with both of my legs and still on recovery process until now. And I'm a single mother. So the only thing I have is my vision and my idea about Poso, about women in Poso and Indonesia. I do have front porch and some chair. That's where I started my idea to build women's school and prayer group. I believe that all we needed is an open and safe place to love, to sharing, to tell together. And then we can stand up and against for our rights. My idea is to bring a woman together. Many of them never talk each other during the conflict. They come from different religions, different ethnic groups, different villages. Even some of them still have trauma and revenge of each other. But I believe that if we can unite women, we can fight against to the major thing who make us have a conflict. Fight to offer against fight the natural resources. We can make women can fight to the violence and sexual abuse from the military and from the sexual abuse in their houses. We can make women have a better decision for better future for our lives. And the most important thing, we can fight against ignorance. My vision in the women's of school is establishment Women's Congress, where for the first time, woman has a voice, a real voice, to spying the policies. How can we do that? We teach local facilitator and also women in the village to have idea about gender equality, religion and peace, and tolerance, and about economic, social, cultural rights, about civil, political rights. This idea is not coming from the fancy NGO in Washington, D.C., or in Jakarta. It's coming from our daily life, our experience, our local wisdom, who losing during the conflict. I believe that if we can using education to teach a woman, to teach a woman and children about a law in Indonesia that can protect them to fight against from the violence and exploitation by the military and the big business, even from the government. If we can reunite women, we can save our land, our life. How we can do that? We are no need a lot of money, no need a nice car, even two legs. Today, if you have cell phone, a pen, and a big idea, you can make it happen, no matter where you are from. I did.